Hey everyone, and welcome to episode 12 of my Let's Build a Medieval Village series. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to build this blacksmith design in the Lower District. This tutorial contains both the exterior and the interior of the build, so I really hope you like the design that I've come up with and enjoy the tutorial. In the next episode, I'd like to build in the fishing area by the docks, so make sure to leave your build requests in the comments for what you'd like to see me build there. As always, the most popular requests will be put into a poll where you can then decide on a winner, which will be featured in the next episode. So, without further ado, let's get on with the tutorial. Here's the location of the build within the Lower District. And here's the outline of the build. The longer sections are 5 blocks across and the shorter sections are 3 blocks across, made using stone bricks and oak logs. The first thing I'm going to do is fill in the middle with a mix of stone bricks, cobblestone, andesite and stone, just like this. Then I'm replacing some of the blocks in the outline just to add some more texture to this too. Now we're going to bring up each of the oak logs by the number shown on screen. So the logs surrounding the larger section will be brought up by 5 blocks, making them 6 blocks tall in total. And the 2 logs at the side will be brought up by 3 blocks, making them 4 blocks tall in total. When you've done that, at the front, add upside down mixed stone stairs between the bottom logs, like this. After that, add another oak log in front of the bottom one with a spruce stair on top. Do this for all of the oak log columns. Now come round to the side and add 4 upside down mixed stone stairs on the left and again on the right, so there's a 3 block gap in the middle like this. Then add the oak log with the spruce stair on top on each side. And do the same across the back and in the 5 block gap at this side too, just like this. Now, in this corner space, add an oak log with a spruce stair on top, on the left and right. Then add 2 more rows of mixed stone blocks, following the shape of the corner. So you should have something that looks like this. Now, in front of these blocks and logs, add mixed stone stairs with the end stairs facing to the side, like this. This will be the entrance to the build. At the top of the oak log on the right, add 2 more that stick out at the top. Do this on the front side too. Then add upside down spruce stairs below them, like this. And do the same on the next 2 logs too, with more sticking out to the right when you get to the end. So it should look like this. Now, for the roof outline here, start by placing a dark oak plank next to the log that sticks out with a slab on the bottom half of it. Then add another slab on top of the log with a plank next to it. After that, add a slab with a stair on top, followed by an upside down stair with a final stair on top of that. Now we're going to do the same on the other side too. There's a graphic on screen to help you if you get stuck. To join the 2 sides together, add an upside down stair in the middle with a stair on top of that and an upside down stair on the back of it. Now, in between the logs, in line with the upside down stair, add upside down spruce stairs on each side, like this, with a spruce trapdoor in the middle. One block up and in front of this, add more upside down stairs facing towards you with a spruce slab in the middle. And to fill in the gap, add a spruce slab on top of the trap door. You can do this by crouching. Then repeat in the next gap, it's exactly the same. When you've done that, for some extra detail, add a spruce button on the ends of the logs. then add spruce trapdoors below all of the upside down stairs. Now, on top of the upside down stairs at the bottom, add some mixed stone walls, like this. And on top of the walls, add a spruce fence on each side with a spruce fence gate in the middle. Then repeat in the next gap too. When that's done, add some sweetberry bushes next to the logs for a bit more colour. Now, to fill in the gap in the roof outline, come inside and add alternating spruce and strip spruce logs here, just like this. And that's the front side completed. Now, come round to the back and do all of this again. It's the same as the front, but the only difference on this side is we aren't adding the bottom slab yet, or the two logs that stick out on the right hand side. So feel free to look back in the video if you get stuck. And there's also a graphic on screen to help you with the roof outline. Once you've done that, come over to the side where we left the gap. On top of the upside down stairs here, add in the walls. There should be four on each side. And on top of these walls, add a spruce fence on the left and right with two fence gates in the middle. Then add in the spruce buttons on the end of the logs that stick out. Now add dark oak slabs coming all the way across to join the bottom of the roof outlines together. And on the next layer, start by adding a spruce slab. Then, next to the log, add a dark oak slab and add another on top as well as one extra on the bottom row so it sticks out like this. After that, add spruce slabs coming all the way across until you get one block away from the log, where we're going to add the dark oak slabs that stick out again, followed by a final spruce slab. So it should look like this. For the next row, we're going to do the exact same. So you should now have three rows filled in like this. When you've done that, come over to the other side. Over here, join the bottom dark oak slabs together along the bottom again. Now, come back to the front and add one spruce slab followed by the dark oak slabs that stick out. After this, add two spruce slabs and then add the dark oak slabs again, like this. This is where the roof outline for the side section will start. So, to build this, add two more dark oak slabs sticking out to the side like this. Below the second slab, add another with two more in front of it. Then add another below the second again with one more in front of it and repeat this once more to complete this side of the outline. Now come round to the back so we can build this side too. Here, add an extra slab on the bottom slab like this. Then repeat what we did on the other side, it's exactly the same. So you should now have this. Now, join the bottom dark oak slabs together across the bottom, like this. To fill this roof section in, start by adding a row of spruce slabs that follows the shape of the roof outline. On the next row, add dark oak slabs, following the same shape again. Then add extra slabs on top of this row so it sticks out, just like this. For the next row, it's spruce again, just like the first one that we filled in. Then carry on doing alternating dark oak and spruce until you get up to the oak log column. These rows will all be at the same level. For the dark oak row that's in line with the oak logs, make these ones stick out, just like we did on the other side. Then finish it off with a final row of spruce. So the roof should now look like this. Back to the main roof now, and we're going to add a spruce slab followed by an extra dark oak slab on the side roof outline with more in front of that, so it sticks out like this. Then add alternating spruce and dark oak slabs for the rest until we reach the dark oak that sticks out, where we're going to repeat what we've just done. For the next layer, add alternating spruce and dark oak slabs going across until you reach the side roof outline. Here, add two spruce slabs, followed by a dark oak, and two more spruce to finish this row off. Here's what the build should look like now with the side roof added. Now, on the left log column, add an oak log that sticks out with a spruce button on the end. Then, at the side, remove the spruce slab and the dark oak slab. Then, add another log that sticks out and hang up a lantern. And do the same on the other side too. On top of the upside down stairs, we're going to add the mixed stone walls again. On top of these walls, add a spruce fence on each side with three fence gates in the middle. Then decorate with a couple of sweetberry bushes on each side. After that, come round to the back and do the same again. Above the fence on the right, add an upside down dark oak stair. Then add a slab on top of this, with one more in front, another half a block up from that, like this, with a dark oak trapdoor at the end. And finish with an upside down spruce stair in line with the one next to it, with a spruce trapdoor for decoration. Then fill in the gap in the middle with a spruce slab. So you should now have this. Now come round to the other side and do the same again. After that, on the other side of the log, add another upside down stair with a trapdoor below it. Repeat this on the other side too. And again on the logs opposite these. On top of these stairs, add spruce planks going all the way across. Fill in the gaps with a dark oak slab, a spruce slab, and another dark oak slab on the right side too. Then add spruce trapdoors in front of the upside down stairs, as well as more below the slabs that we just added in the corners. Now do the same on the other side too. When you've done that, come inside the build. On the top oak log in the middle columns, add an upside down spruce stair like this. Then add a couple of spruce slabs on top of the upside down stairs to form small arches to fill in the gap. Do this on both sides. After that, in line with the top of the upside down stairs, add spruce slabs going all the way around the room. When you get to the wall with the gap, add three slabs coming across, so it lines up with the walls. Do this on each side, then continue adding the slabs around the room. So you should have this. Now add some spruce trapdoors below the upside down stairs, like this. Then add an extra slab in each corner and hang a lantern from them. On the back wall, add four slabs coming across, like this. Do this on both sides. Below these slabs, add an upside-down stair. Then add a spruce trapdoor in front of it, leave a gap, then add another. Then repeat on the other side too. When you've done that, on top of the spruce slabs that we added, place sideways facing stripped spruce logs going all the way around, like this. Now, on the longer sides, remove the corner log and place four oak logs there instead. After that, count across by five blocks, remove another log and add four oak logs. There should be a four block gap in between them. Then come to the next corner and do the same again. So you should now have this. In front of these logs, remove the slab and add an oak log here with a spruce stair on top. Do this for all three of the columns. On top of the stripped spruce logs, add a spruce fence on each side with fence gates in between. Do this on both sides. Now, between the oak logs, add an upside down spruce stair on each side like this. Then add a spruce trapdoor below these stairs with two more in the middle to create an arch. After that, add an extra log that sticks out of the top oak log on each side. Now come over to the next gap and do the same again. So it should look like this. Now we're going to repeat all of this again on the opposite side. It's exactly the same as what we've just built, so feel free to look back in the video if you get stuck. When you've done that, at the front, add two oak logs that stick out. Then add an upside down spruce stair below them and repeat on the other side too. Then add a spruce button at the end of these logs. For the roof outline, start by adding a dark oak plank on top of the end log. Then add a block half a block down from this with a slab sticking out of the bottom, like this. After that, add a slab next to the plank at the top with a stair on top of it. And finally, add an upside down stair on the back of it with another stair on top. Now come over to the other side and do the same again. There's a graphic on screen to help you if you get stuck. To fill in the gap in the middle, add an upside down stair with a stair on top and another upside down stair on the back of that. Now, come over to the other side and repeat what we've just done. It's exactly the same. Behind the roof outline, on top of the logs, add alternating spruce and stripped spruce logs to fill in the space. There'll be a one block gap between this and the roof outline here. Then do the exact same on the other side too. After that, come over to the lower roof outline. Here we're going to add a torch to light up this gap. Then, using spruce, we're going to connect this roof outline to the wall behind it, like this. At the top, use dark oak to fill this part in. Then repeat on the other side. So it should look like this. Now, below the upper roof outline, add two slabs, followed by another two, with an upside down stair in the middle, and repeat the slabs again to fill in the gap. Then, at the top of the lower roof outline, add an extra slab with two more at the end for a bit of extra detail. And in the corner at the bottom, add an extra spruce slab and hang a lantern from it. Now, come over to the opposite side and do this again. It's exactly the same. As the front's a little bit different, we're going to add a lantern on both sides this time. Now, at the front where the slabs at the top stick out, add a grindstone like this, then hang a chain from it. You can do this by crouching. On the chain, hang a spruce plank. Then surround this with glow item frames. To decorate, I've just used a couple of iron swords and iron ingots, but you can use whatever you'd like. Now, for the main roof at the top, start by joining the bottom slabs together, going all the way across. For the next layer, add two spruce slabs, followed by a dark oak slab. Then add three spruce with dark oak in the very centre. Then repeat until you get to the other side. So it should look like this. Now repeat this to fill in the rest of the roof, using the same block types from the roof outlines and lining up the dark oak parts with the layer below. Then do the exact same on the other side too. And across the top, add dark oak slabs. For some extra detail at the top, add a couple of extra slabs at the end, like this. Then add more slabs spaced one block apart, all the way across, with two extra at the end again. When you've done the roof, in the corners at the bottom, hang up a lantern on all sides. And that's the roof and the main structure of the build completed. I forgot to add in a button by the entrance, so make sure you add that in too. Now, come inside the build and look up. To make the ceiling a bit neater, head up to the top and fill in the gaps above the arches, like this. When you've done that, add spruce slabs going all the way across, directly below the first row on the roof. For the next row, add slabs half a block up from this, going all the way across. And for the top row, go up by half a block again. You can add a couple of torches up here, just to make sure that no bats spawn. For the last two rows, come down by half a block each time, mirroring what we did on the other side. When you've done that, where the spruce logs are, add extra slabs going all the way across, so you have this. Then add a lantern in the middle. In the centre, do this again, one block before the oak log, like this. Then repeat this two more times, in line with the oak log and one block after it, so this section is three blocks wide. And on the final side, do this once more and hang up another lantern. Now, in the middle, add an upside down spruce stair in line with the trap doors, like this. Do this on both sides. On top, add a slab with a block in front and a final slab in the middle to create this arch shape. After that, on the top half of the stripped spruce logs, add spruce slabs going all the way around. and finish it off by adding an extra slab in each corner, just like this. Now, turn to face the gap in the side wall. To the side of this gap, in front of the wall, add a mix of cobbled deep slate and deep slate bricks leading up to the roof here. Do this on both sides. Now, in the three-block gap, do the same again to fill this in. If you've placed any temporary blocks here, you'll have to remove them. After that, on the left and right, add a block with a stair on top, like this. Then, in the middle, remove these three blocks and also the blocks below them. Then place down three campfires with magma blocks on top, so it looks like hot coals. Above these, add some slabs, placed on the top half of the block. Then in front of these slabs, add an upside down stair on each side with a slab in the middle to create a table. Now, on top of the slabs, add three rows of furnaces. Fill in the gap above the furnaces with a mix of deep slate blocks. Then, on the left and right, add an upside down stair. On top of these stairs, add a slab. Then, next to these slabs, place blocks. In the middle, add an upside down stair. Remove the spruce slab above, then place a block with a stair on top of it. And that's the furnace completed. Now, at the back there's a small gap, so you can just add a spruce slab here to fill it in. After you've done that, come round to the back of this and we're going to make a chimney. To do this, in the middle, add a mix of deep slate blocks, leading up to the roof like this. Then, on either side of this, add a few more blocks with a stair on top, like this. It doesn't have to be exactly the same as mine, it can be whatever shape you think looks best. And in the middle again, add a block with a stair on top. Now, on the roof, add a stair on either side with a block in the middle. Add in another block and place a stair on top like this. Add an upside down stair on the back of that with another stair on top. Then add a final upside down stair on the back of this with a block on top so the chimney sticks out. Now just add in a few more blocks and stairs to make the chimney have a bit more support and structure, and feel free to swap out any blocks to make the texturing a bit more random. When you're happy with the way that the chimney looks, add a campfire at the very top and surround it with spruce trapdoors to finish it off. And for a bit of decoration on this side, you can add in some sweet berry bushes at the bottom. When you finish that off, come back inside the build. Next to the furnace, place some barrels facing in different directions. Then add a smithing table and an armour stand like this. Now, come over to the other side and add a crafting table, a couple of barrels, an anvil and another armour stand. Then you can add an item frame with some raw iron in on the table for a bit of extra decoration. To make it look like the furnace is regularly used, you can also replace some of the blocks in the floor with deep slate, so it looks like the floor's a bit dirty from all of the coal and smoke. Now, at the top, on the spruce slabs, add an armour stand on each side like this. To decorate the ones at the top, I've used iron armour, so it looks like these are the more expensive sets on display. And at the bottom, I've used chainmail, so these ones look a bit cheaper. When you've done that, in the space at the side, make another table and decorate it using an item frame with anything you like in it and a flower pot to look like a pot to store tools. Then turn to face the other side and do the same again. In front of the middle column, add a grindstone, then head into the remaining space at the side. In here, along the back, add 5 deep slate stairs like this. It might be a bit tricky to place these because there's not much space. Turn the corner and add another 2 stairs like this. Then come back across the front and around to the side so it all joins together. Now, inside this, remove the blocks in the middle and the row below that too. At the bottom, place 3 hay bales. Then add 3 campfires on top of them and finish with 3 magma blocks. The hay bales will make the smoke from the campfires go up higher. Where the smoke touches the roof, remove these blocks so the smoke can go outside. Now, around the blocks that we removed, add upside down deep slate stairs so it looks a bit like a funnel. Again, it might be a bit tricky to place these as there isn't a lot of room. If there's any gaps, just add an extra slab there, and you can also remove some slabs if the stairs don't line up properly too. When you've done that, head onto the roof and remove the slabs surrounding the hole that we made so you can see the deep slate from the stairs below. On top of these stairs, add some deep slate blocks and slabs at random heights to create another chimney. I've tried to make the heights of these different to the blocks next to them and opposite so it looks random. So you should end up with something that looks like this. Now, head back inside and add an anvil along the side wall. After that, next to the middle column, add some open spruce trapdoors to create this box shape. And inside of this, add some water. For some final decoration, add a few more barrels on the side of the log, again, facing in different directions, and some more outside of the build by the steps. Now, to finish everything off, I'm just connecting this build to the main path that I've marked out using a mix of cobblestone, stone, stone bricks, and andesite. And finally, I'm just going around the build with some bone meal to add some long grass and flowers to finish it all off. And that's the blacksmith completed. I really hope you liked the build and found the tutorial easy to follow. Remember to add your build request for what you'd like to see in the fishing area down in the comments section so you can vote on a winning build. Thank you so much for watching. If you did enjoy the video, I'd really appreciate it if you could leave a like. And if you aren't already, please consider subscribing to see more content like this.